Okay, so we are at the end of this 3-day long event. I hope all of you, those also who are joining in from elsewhere, enjoyed this. Special thanks to Paolo and Shaila Spadoza, who is sitting in the back, and of course, their entire team. We had a very lot of people contributed to this, making this a success. And this has really been a landmark event to mark the success of 30 years of our diploma program. As you know, something like 1,000 students from 80 different countries have gone through ICTP. And our goal is to really establish this worldwide network, a global community of ICTP. And it's very good to see some of the speeches I heard from the students from Vietnam, for example, that they will add to the community, existing communities there, and make it grow. As we have seen, the regional chapter in Pakistan has already started. And we now had very good discussions with regional chapters elsewhere. So I'm quite, there was a lot of very positive energy, as we all noticed. And I hope we are able to translate that into concrete going forward. So first of all, thank you, all of you. We have celebrated the accomplishments and of our diploma alumni. I think about 90% have gone on to do masters, advanced masters or doctoral degree programs. And as we have seen, they have become leaders, some of them in the scientific discipline of their interest or in other fields, whether in finance or in politics, helping build a strong scientific base in their own countries, or sometimes working from as in the diaspora and contributing to their countries. So it's really great to see the impact that ICTP has had. They were also, I mean, as we said, part of the purpose of this was not only to celebrate the past, but to see what we can do to build a more organized global community, especially taking advantage of some of these new tools that have become available to us now through, you know, maybe through online platforms. And a lot of Fernando summarized some of these suggestions that have come up forward. You know, mentoring was one of them. Mentoring program for women was another one. Building an alumni database and to develop collaborative research opportunities, and to develop the ICTP global community through regional networks. And of course, to implement these initiatives is going to be challenging. We first of all need to find ways to broaden our resources because, for example, if you want to increase the number of students or we want to expand in new directions. But we have to remember when Abdus Salam started, you know, ICTP was not built in 5 or 10 years, you know, it has taken several decades. And he started with 2 or 3 faculty members. He was at Imperial College. And so we should take inspiration from that. And it's going to take patience and long-term commitment. But I'm very happy to see that all of you feel that real connection with ICTP. I think this is something which was a very heartwarming experience to see from diverse set of people. You can rest assured that, I mean, ICTP is very committed to this. I mean, I can give you my assurance that we really want to put our efforts into developing this community. We really need you to be the partners in this undertaking. You have to be active, and it's good to see that people are taking initiative. I mean, as I said, this whole thing started with initiative from students and not from ICTP management. You know, that's not how it should work. Also, for regional chapters, the initiative has come from you. And I hope that it continues like that. And I hope that, you know, all this very beautiful sentiment that was expressed today, and the, you know, sort of the joy of being in a family like ICTP, I hope we can use that as a for translating into something more constructive and long-term. At this stage, I'm supposed to say some inspiring words. You know, I'm not very good at that. I believe that more than words, the concrete achievements of ICTP really speak for themselves. And just to quote, I think the best way to take inspiration is, I just will give you some quotes from yesterday's discussion, like Freddy Cacciazzo, who is now the Dyson professor at Perimeter, former diploma student from Venezuela. And he said that ICTP is the place where people believe in you. And he described how ICTP was a crucial stepping stone that allowed him to go to Harvard and to Princeton and to, you know, excel in his career. Dr. Diane, who is now the vice president of finance, he said that ICTP does not only produce scientists. I mean, this is something that goes back to our discussion before. Then the Honorable Minister of Education of Lesotho, Dr. Rapapa, who was also a former, is an alumni, he said that ICTP unlocks people's potential. And he gave examples of how, you know, in policy making, in political discussions, having this approach of as a scientist was crucial to his perspective and his career. And I think, I mean, that is really fundamental to the mission of ICTP. Science is not, I mean, we all take inspiration for the wonderful science that happens at ICTP, or the talk that we heard, a beautiful testimony to the community of science that we have, of making this impossibly complicated experiments really possible. And, you know, looking at, you know, so far away, you know, thousands of light years away, and really being able to say with certainty that there is a black hole over there. And that's one part of aspect of science, this excitement at the frontiers of science. But also, I think more broadly as citizens, a culture of open-mindedness, also diversity that we see here, inclusiveness, and facts-based inquiry, which is really important in this age of misinformation, to create informed policies, which we have seen in the time of COVID, that we really need a scientific way of assessing what is available to you. And I think you can play a role in whatever capacity, many different ways, either as scientists or as policymakers, or as our financial managers. So, in fact, I do want to say that we have to make an effort, you know, as it is also with friends. We have to make an effort to keep in touch. It's we will try to find ways to do it. If you know, you should bother us. I think if you think that the connection is missing, and there are some activities already that you might be of interest, but we are trying to find a way. As I told you, ICTP is trying to create a global, more accessible platform for alumni to remain connected. But, you know, it could take a year or two, you know, before we can really put all the elements in place. But there are some activities which could be of interest to you. For example, yesterday's speaker, Professor Shobhana Narasimhan, she gave this very nice talk about women in science, women in physics. So there is actually going to be a workshop in 15th and 17th of November for women in physics, which could be of interest to some of the budding physicists here, half of them, as I can see. I would end with thanking you. I don't want to make a long speech. I think we have nice weather outside and we can go to the terrace to enjoy. So thank you in advance and I look forward to remain connected with you, and that you will play an active role in making ICTP's mission even greater than what it is. Thank you very much.